Camera footage of Rochester, New York police officers tackling and pepper spraying a black mother has caught national attention.
Would you stop backing up? Okay. Put the kid down.
Okay, okay.
Put the kid down. Put your arms behind your back now. Put your arms behind your back. Stop. 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 Turn around. Stop. 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 Relax. Relax. Turn over so I can cuff you. We're going to cuff you. You need to stop.
She's fine.
The daughter was not pepper sprayed or injured in the incident, police confirmed during a Friday press conference. The mother can be seen in the footage running away from officers before they caught up to her, tackled her, and pepper sprayed her after she sat the child down. The officer involved in the arrest has been placed on administrative leave. Pending the outcome of a police investigation into the incident, the interim chief confirmed on Friday. The woman was charged with trespassing over the incident. So it's interesting that they say that the child was not harmed during the course of this arrest, because it sounds to me like that child is being traumatized for life. Sure. That's number one. Number two, the fact that she's been charged with trespassing, does it really, 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 was that show of force necessary? That was excessive force. That was absolutely ridiculous. I don't know. I don't care what it is that she is accused of doing. Mm-hmm. It does not warrant that type of behavior.
Nope.
And when we're thinking about that black cop last week who was swiftly fired for using a colloquialism that we all use when we're in the privacy of our own homes and around our homies, mm-hmm. and this guy is on administrative leave and probably with pay, I am disgusted.
Melissa, I literally was in tears watching this video.
It's horrifying.
It is an awful video. I mean, honestly, what I felt was most important to add in here, Melissa, I mean, excellent point to mention. Yes, the child was harmed. You know, it might not have been physically, but she might have been physically harmed, actually, because you were moving her around. But what mm-hmm. I thought was interesting, when you guys get a chance to watch the beginning of the video, she opened her purse. She told the cop, I didn't steal anything. She's telling him, like, hey, the cop hopped out on level 100. He hopped out of the car. You saw it, Romeo, right? Mm-hmm. He hopped out of the car on level 30. I mean, he was ready. You think about this woman. She lives in Rochester, the same place where she saw what happened to Daniel Prude mm-hmm. in her own town. She saw that happen. I personally don't feel like she was running away from the police. What I would have done in that state of fear, I would have just ran to be closer to around people. She was around mm-hmm. on the side corner. No one was over there. Mm-hmm. So I personally felt like she was just running to be around so that people could get it on camera and mm-hmm. see what was going on. That's what I felt deeply in my heart, and I prayed that whatever they were looking for, they don't find it, and that she can sue them for everything that they possibly have, because this was terrible to watch.
Amen.
It's a black woman who's scared to death, and obviously part of the training for Rochester Police Department is pepper spraying whoever they can, right? But no need for that. There was no need at all. And you think about the girl, like you said, she's going to carry this for the rest of her life. And I always go back when I talk about that is, you wonder why there's this huge gap between our community and the police department. This is why. That little girl is going to carry that with her for the rest of her life. And her feelings may never change when it comes to that.
I always like to check in with what activists are saying when we have incidents like this, so that we're just not giving you black pain. You know, we're talking about it from all different corners, mm-hmm. right? And so people who want to reform the police would create a system where that officer would be punished for this. People who want to defund the police would create a system where this didn't happen in the first place.
Mm-hmm. I mean, Brooke, a really quick tweet, he's not anybody, it's just a person on Twitter said, Rochester police maced a mother holding a three-year-old child, no amount of training can fix that, defund the police. That goes right into what you were saying, Brooke. I mean, just amazing. Okay, moving right along, because you guys see when I get fired up, I start getting all over the place. Okay, we're focused. Okay, school officials and local police, they are investigating a Texas mother's allegations that her son, a black middle schooler, was repeatedly bullied and forced to drink urine by a group of students, according to NBC News.
This is not a prank. This is beyond bullying. You are evil. They are evil.
The mother, Summer Smith, detailed the alleged abuse in a lengthy Facebook post. She wrote that her son's inhaler was taken by a coach. He was called racial and homophobic slurs and attacked with a BB gun. Her son, Samarian Humphrey, is a student at Haggard Middle School in Plano, a suburb of Dallas. Now, of course, I did a little bit of digging on this as well. I mean, absolutely, this is not a prank. This is, you know, hatred in all forms. But I was reading that the coach that took his inhaler still works at the school. Unless anyone read anything different, the last thing that I read was that the coach and the children should all be held accountable for these actions. All of them. Everyone should be held accountable.
1,000%.
It makes me nervous when I think about my son going back to school, because I hear him online just playing games and how he can be bullied that way, how it starts mentally, right? And, you know, and I quickly, like, I always air hustle when he's playing, so I will go check him. If someone's disrespecting you, these are the steps you take. You don't whine to be around someone. You can't fall into that. But this is so disgusting. Like, as a parent, I'm up at that school, and it's going to be a problem.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be a major problem with this situation. That can't happen. That can't, and it all happened from a sleepover. They tried to get him to come over and then abuse this kid. She did not know that. She assumed that they were friends because they invited him over, and that's what happened.
And that is so insidious. Like, the fact that kids think that way. And just a tiny little sidebar, his mother is stunning. It's just, that was just what I was thinking while she was talking. I was just really taking in this beautiful, strong Black woman defending her child in a manner in which she should never have to do so. Mm. So, you know, happy International Women's Day.
I think about what you said, Romeo, about, you know, being a parent. Mm-hmm. Being a parent, and you're in this position where, you know, you can teach your child all of these ways to protect himself and stand up for himself and have certain level of self-confidence and also know that he can always come to you. And then to another certain extent, there's nothing you can do about what another child might do. So adults have to be persistent all around.
Yes.
Not just, you know what I mean? Like the parent of the child that this happened to, we need adults everywhere to be making sure that, you know, we know what's going on.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm.